Hot Larva and the Strand here again, another episode of Farming Simulator 15. We're playing on the Bjornholm map. And I'm still continuing to harvest yet. Once this guy turns around here, I want to kind of show you guys what the auto tractor did. And kind of the reason why I recommend it. You got a square field like this, you're just better off using a regular hired worker. He kind of messed up the field good down there at the other end, so not exactly sure what he did to do that, but yeah, he seemed to do okay on this end. This end's, you know, fairly nice straight line. Looked like he stopped fairly consistently at the end there each time. Right now I'm just running a regular hired worker. The only trouble with that is he keeps getting stuck down at the other end there. There's not enough room to turn around, so I could probably fix that if I did a couple headlands, which I haven't done yet, but while we're looking at this tractor, I know I got a count. Someone was saying, yes, European version here, obviously got the flotation tires, common European thing, I guess. And this exhaust, too, must be a European-style type exhaust. I guess that's something common in Europe to see it mounted like that. Again, I'm not sure why that seems kind of weird to me, but you know, commonly, at least the exhaust that I've seen there, they looks more like this, the one on this side. Which is your air intake, by the way. Yeah, normally it would be mounted straight up and down there, but whatever. Looks kind of weird that way, you know, if you get in the cab, it's like, that's weird looking at it, seeing that there, but yeah. There is a dual-wheel version, by the way. I know someone commented and asked about that. It is on LS2015. It's probably on the other websites, too, but that's where I happened to see it, was LS2015. And there's also a triple-wheeled version as well, for those of you interested. And we'll get to the other end here. We're going to do some logging this episode. But before we do that, I thought I'd show you guys what the hired worker did over here. Might screw this guy up. I'm not entirely sure yet. I've had to fix basically each round now so far he's screwed up. Yeah, as you can see up about this point here, he was doing okay, and then I don't know what happened, but he started going diagonally up and down the field that way. So yeah. As you can see, this bit's been replanted already. This guy's probably... Oh, he's gonna stop, period. How nice, yeah. That's pretty much what's been happening. So every time he stops, I gotta come back over here, get him going again. And by the way, for some reason, hire him here. For some reason, the GPS mod does not appear to work on this tractor. I'm not sure why. It works on all my other tractors, but I cannot get the GPS mod to work on this tractor. It doesn't show up. Nothing happens. So I'm not sure what's up with this tractor, but the GPS mod does not work on it. Kind of weird. Anyway, let's hop over to our logging area. Actually, well, let's take the pickup over there. Why not? He's done planting that field. Looks like I need to fertilize this field yet. Maybe we'll grab that a minute before we head down to the logging area. Looks like you're done with that field. Okay. Should be the last field that needs to be fertilized right there, I believe. And while we're driving here, we'll probably put up some comments. Dustin was saying he loves all my videos. Thank you for that. Okay, probably should put some fertilizer in here too, otherwise it's gonna cost me more money. Apparently he must have ran out at some point there. Michael was saying, Randy, the freight yard's a fooler. Most of the time it's the most money. The PDA only shows half the amount after you deliver the grain. Pull the handle, get the other half. Yes, he's correct on that. Freight yard is... basically gives you double what it actually says it gives you, so... surprised that actually hasn't been fixed with the update. I rather suspected something would have been done about that, because that seems, doesn't seem right. Because, I mean, why go anywhere else with your crops? I mean, you can simply bring everything compared to the freight yard and get double the price, which is... has to be, I'm pretty sure, more than anything else. I don't think anything would be double. Yeah, nothing's even really close to being double anywhere else. Might be 100, you know, a couple hundred bucks more, but that's going to be about it. So, okay, should be all set here. Let's grab our pickup. Speaking of the pickup, doped up maniacs. That purple looks like crazy plum that Dodge puts on their cars. Says nice, good choice. And it doesn't look too bad, actually. It's not like a crazy, annoying purple. Oh crap, we're not gonna make that turn. Definitely a little bit hard to drive the pickup. It's very slidey, slippery, it seems like. But then again, I mean, who would be? Whoa, crap. It would be going, you know, 50 mile an hour down a snowy slope like this. Now we just gave that poor old lady in that car a heart attack. Looks like we're going to top out about 51 mile an hour there. Bit of air time there. So yeah, you guys can kind of see this is the entire area I've deforested so far. Mainly got that stuff down that way. It's taken down yet, so we'll probably get started on that this episode, I guess. There's a couple bits and pieces laying around here and there. I'll probably, to be honest, just grind them up. Hardly worth taking the time to pick them up. Unless maybe I drive this thing around and pick them up. That might work. Moving the big truck all the time to do it. It's hardly worth it. Oh, I should mention, too, I'm using Fraps to do the recording this time. The last couple episodes, I keep having trouble with the video not turning out really good, so I'm not sure what's going on there. Thought I had that issue solved, but then it seems to have popped back up again. Probably should pick that piece up. That piece down there is probably worth a fair amount. That's one big stump to grind out. Yeah, we'll just leave it set for now a moment, I guess. I may cut that lower at some point. Hey, some mushrooms there. Hey, won't be there long anymore with all the trees cut down. Speaking of cutting trees down, this thing is now supposed to do 8-meter long pieces, so... I think that'll actually fit in our big truck a little better. Makes a little more sense to me, anyway. I actually haven't checked that out since then, but it's supposed to. Let's see. Change cut length is O. Oh, it doesn't give you the option to do half meters anymore. It always used to be, you know, 1.5, 2, 2.5, 3.5, etc. Oop, not that one. Now it just does 1 meter increments. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Doesn't go any higher, does it? Nope. 8 is the highest. Well, I see no reason why not to do the highest. Makes the most sense to me, anyway. Now, where's a good spot to set up? Probably down in the middle there. Probably looks pretty good place to start doing this. Okay. Yeah, it should work pretty good. Just double check, we got it set on 8 meters. Yep. So this should be much longer pieces this time. Yeah, that does look like a much longer piece. Should save some time on loading that too. You know, obviously won't have so many pieces for a tree. That was, what, 5 pieces there? Oh crap, I think we just dipped over. Yeah, we did. That seems to be happening more often since the update. I'm not sure if added more weight to the trees or what's happened. I noticed that with my trailer now too. It's like ever since the update, I've been having trouble with the trailer when I'm going down the road. It seems to want to tip over a lot more. Definitely find myself having to baby the turns a lot more than I used to or remember having to. And I suppose they have fixed the issue with the ghost trees as well, so hopefully we won't have any issues with that. I think what we have, 3 of them the last time I think I did the logging, which is kind of unusual to have 3 of them. I've never had that many before. Hopefully that issue is fixed. The stump grinding definitely seems to be much better now as well. I did grind out some stumps here. That was actually a couple episodes back. And that seemed to go pretty good. I didn't have any issues with the stump grinder kind of bugging out like it normally always did. And yes, I know it may look like I'm making a mess of this wood pile. That's kind of the idea. Kind of makes it a little easier to pick them up with a crane. Always, if they're all laying perfectly, that you can't get the craning down in between the logs. Makes it really hard to pick them up. So, like these two on top here, now there's only 2 of them. Oh, if I can get around here. There we go. See, I could probably pick these up okay. I could pick up 2 of them. But you get like 3 of them side by side. Yeah, they're not really side by side, but like these 3 here might be a little bit of a problem. They're probably far enough apart they won't be, but if you were to have like 3 of them like this that were that close together, and that crane has to come pick them up, getting that crane down in there to actually pick them up just does not work well at all. So I've been finding actually a messy pile actually works better. Haven't had this thing cut any trees down by itself yet. That's a good thing. That was another complaint I had. That's why some of the stumps are kind of unusually long. This thing would touch the tree and just start cutting it down. Don't think I've seen anybody else or heard anybody else saying they've had that problem, but I certainly have. Oh, what else we got for comments here? Farmer Mike said I got $57 for the eggs. Ah, good. At least somebody was paying attention. I knew we got some money for the eggs, but I did not know how much. So thank you for that. Actually, I wonder, does that say it anywhere on our financial page? Probably not. Let's see. Finances. Yeah, we got $597 in new vehicles. Property maintenance, $1. I wonder what that's actually for. $1. Interesting. Property maintenance. Wage payment. It cost us about $7,000 there to plant everything from the looks of it. Other $297. Kind of wondering. Probably field costs, I'm guessing. Anyway, not a very pretty looking balance sheet there. A little too much red on it, if you ask me. But yeah, we'll definitely be working on getting this back into the green here pretty quick. Let's do some logging again. Got plenty of canola planted. That should bring us some good money. Kind of funny, you watch the branches kind of phase through the vehicle. Supposedly they fixed this thing too, so it will make it up hills much better now. Can't say I really noticed or had much problem with that in the past, so can't say I really noticed anything yet. I mean, it seems to be pretty good so far. Like I said, I didn't have much problem in the past, so it's gonna tip over. Yeah, they must have added some weight to the trees or something, I'm thinking. It definitely seems a lot more tippy. I had it with the other crane there too. I've tipped that thing over like several times. It's like, that's weird. I've never had problems with that before. Well, I have, but usually because I'm doing something stupid. Not when I'm just picking up one branch off, trying to, you know, put it in the trailer. Yeah, this thing is definitely the way to go as far as cutting trees goes, though. Down a lot of trees in a big hurry. Works great for, you know, de-limbing them and chopping them into the correct size hunks. Hopefully these are the correct size. They'll fit on that trailer with no problem, I'm hoping. Obviously, 3 meters longer, so... I'm thinking they'll fit on the trailer with no problem, I'm hoping. And if they don't, oh well. Going, another tree bites the dust. Yeah, any of you tree huggers out there might not be wanting to watch it at this point. Yeah, this is one camera I really don't use much on this thing. I don't really see the use of it myself, but... probably almost time to start another pile here. It's getting a little bit big. Maybe we'll cut down that one that's there yet, and then we'll call this pile good. Oh crap. Is the thing stuck in there? There we go. That's finally out. Good. Spotter Sky was saying, hey, RDAllen, perhaps you would help to make a slope where you dump the tree trunks so that the trailer can reach the trigger point. Not exactly sure what you're referring to there, but... You mean the one by the water or the actual one by the train? Okay, I think we'll call that pretty good. We've done enough damage there for the moment. Looks like we make another pile like that, we'll probably have probably the most or the rest of these trees. That'll just leave some in the back there. Which I may not get all of those. Some of them are kind of, you know, down in there a bit. A little bit hard to get down there. We might just leave them. Okay, let's grab a tractor and grind out some of these stumps. Make it a little bit easier for us to get in there with a trailer. It'd help if I get in the tractor, probably. Okay, we'll just start with a stump right here. Why not? Actually, you know what? I'm not going to be able to see from that view, am I? Okay, let's stick with the outside view. As you see, it seems to work much better now. That bug out, it does actually chop down the stump every time, it seems like. Of course, as soon as I say that, now it's going to have one that's not going to. Great demand at the biogas plant for silage. We do not have any silage. Like I said, though, definitely want to get into that next, so... That's weird. Well, this will be the first one since the update I've had that hasn't ground out properly. Oh, there it went, finally. Doesn't help him on sitting on a slope here. That's probably part of the problem. Let's see if we can actually get that yet. Turn around here, get this up. There we go. Another one that's not going to grind out properly. Nope, that one went. Okay. Or did it? I've seen some... I think, is it sticking out just a little bit there yet? Oh, it is sticking out just a little bit. Okay, sneaky little thing. There we go. For you folks, maybe it won't show up in the video, but there's just a thin little sliver sticking out there yet. Oh, whoever cut that tree down really cut it down close. That one. That's a tall buck right there. Should we only get this high enough to go up there? Yeah, maybe. Always that one last little piece that doesn't want to go all the time. Again, there's just a thin little sliver there. If I can zoom in, I can't really zoom in to show you guys that. Yeah, just that little sliver there. That's what it's grinding out yet. Hey, we got it that time. Okay. Excellent. Now let's grind out the ones around here so we get the truck in there. There we go. Push that one piece of log back in there. Piece of log down in there. How nice. Except I don't think I can see this one. Must be one there though, because it's got the wood chips. That's interesting. Let's see if we can get rid of it here a minute. Otherwise, I'm not going to worry about it because I can't see it. So. Apparently they haven't fixed everything with this log chopper yet for the Stumps. Seems to have a few bugs in it yet. Anyway, folks, I think we better call it an episode there. If you have any comments or questions, be sure to leave them below. And as always, thanks for watching, and until next time.